Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 and our Smash the Patriarchy campaign. Alright, so I was looking around a little bit as to what I might want to do going forward. And, yeah, there aren't too many people with, claims and stuff that we can easily press right now. Right now, about the only one who has anything worthwhile is Duke Manuel of Capua, who does have a strong claim on the Prince Bishopric of Benevento. The problem is that the barony is held by the Pope. So I'm not so sure that that's the best way to go. Now, he does have the... he is a duke. He is the Duke of Capua. So I could press his de jure ducal claim for King Humbert's own personal county. Which probably, let's see, he will probably get kicked out to Palermo. So, that's not bad, I guess. I'm not sure if there's going to be a way to vassalize this guy directly, unfortunately. But I don't know that I need another, I need more... I don't know that I'll need more merchant republics besides Genoa and Ancona and perhaps eventually Venezia. So, for now, let's go ahead and get right back into it. We are gaining money. Not a whole lot, but we are gaining some. Gladly accept the guardianship contract. That's good. I did see that there was a... That is a pretty big Burgundian liberation revolt. That is not really going to affect me too much. Unless he moves into my territory. I do think that I want to go ahead and build up my castle walls here, though. Go ahead and let time continue. Don't have any castle walls that I can build up here. Aww, damn it. This is the diligent gregarious guy that I just sent that kid to be educated by. Alright. So, let's see. Find characters. Search realm. Search vassals. Alright, you're gregarious. Alright, let's try diligent. Okay, there are a couple. Right now I kind of need some diligent gregarious people, so you can have Ankara. There we go. And I think it was his kid. Assign guardian. Actually, there's a few more out there. No, that's not pulling the right thing. Alright. There we go. Try to get him to be Italian. He's currently betrothed to you. You are quick. Countess of Vienne, but I don't think you're going to inherit that. Glad they accept the guardianship contract. Very good. I can hold a summer fair. Go ahead and do that. Local nobles of Florence complain about too many peasants entering the city during the summer fair. Deal with it. Stop sieging down my lands. Not going to get involved there, though. An errant monk is disturbing the summer fair by preaching about sins and the end of the world. His drivel is frightening some, but most of the crowd around him is mocking and laughing at him. He's just another part of the entertainment. Oh, it's fine. I'll leave a little bit, lose a little bit of piety. What do you want? Counselor. You want me to be your chancellor? No. No thanks. Not right now. So. I mean, I can always go after Napoli at any time. But I suppose to a certain extent it doesn't really matter for him. I mean, he'll either create a vassal out of it, or he will keep it for himself and deal with the penalty for having, you know, the incorrect land type. I mean, I think he would still gain some money out of it. Distressing vision. Oh, actually, that reminds me. I do not have enough to request a rank up. Okay. Alright, let's go. Let's see. You are attacking in a holy war for Kabilia. Which one exactly is that? Alright, so you're going on a holy war for just this one piece of territory. Interesting. I'm actually pretty impressed at Pisa right now. And unfortunately, my wife is homosexual, frail, envious, and gluttonous, but, you know, what are you going to do, right? He's converted a fair number of the counties to Italian already, so I'm going to look forward to eventually taking that. but yeah, let's see. So, what do I really want to do? So if I take this, then he might fabricate a claim on Foggia. I might fabricate a claim on Salerno. Might fabricate a claim on Amalfi. Of course, he might also fabricate a claim on Napoli, which is dumb. But let's see, what do we have? We can claim Benevento. I can claim Salerno. Nah, none of those are interesting. Let's go ahead and claim Benevento. The council will vote. Wow, everyone is voting yes. Holy cow. Yeah, you would gain a title. You like that. I have a whole bunch of loyalists. I did not realize it. Works for me. All right. Oops. Should have held down control. Oh. Oops. Double oops. Yeah, I should have held down control. I just wasn't thinking about it because I wasn't actually at war. It's not going to affect my war score, so it doesn't really matter. Alright, let's see. Let's get you two... Come down there. You don't have any troops yet, but you do have some ships. What else do you have again? Ah, yes. It's Lower Lorraine. Oh, actually, you know what? Where's your seat of power again? Ah, that's not enough troops. Not enough boats, anyway. Alright, never mind. I was thinking I could just raise them up on Corsica, and that would be just fine. Alright, I think I'm going to have to wait for these two little wars to end, battles to end. It was a mistake inviting the jumping Jews of Jerusalem to the summer fair. They are jumping at different rhythms despite the rhythmic twang of a harp. They tirelessly keep jumping, 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 until one of them loses his balance and falls towards his brothers, causing all of them to fall to the floor. I could say I want my money back, or the end was fun. 25% chance that I gain Gregarious? Dang it. Alright, that's fine. You go wherever you want to go. Still going to Roma. That's good. Fine with you going there. Alright. Let's just bring everyone together. The peddlers are loading their wares, and the merchants are taking down their stalls. The jugglers, strolling players, and other entertainers are preparing to leave. The summer fair is over for this year. It was great fun. Almost got Gregarious, and that is that would have been fantastic. Oh, I missed what that other one was. Alright, got 4K here. That's good enough to hop into Benevento. I'll move the rest of you in. You guys should all be together now. I don't really need your boats then. Okay, so I'll go ahead and take Benevento for Capua. It's fine. Daughter was born to Ankara, who is quick. So let's go ahead and give you a thrift focus. Might even marry you off to a lesser Deaconosa. To Master Asmodeus, a neophyte Gil is a greedy, slothful idiot who deserves none of the riches in his possession. What do you say, brother? Shall we raid his laboratory and claim that which should be ours? No! Never. I accidentally grabbed my retinue. Retinue, go home. Actually, retinue, go down to Capua, guard the border. I've invited people in my court to take part in a war game, which we practice defending our land from invading armies. We will use wooden models to represent invading armies, and I shall have to use clever tactics to defeat my opponents. This will be fun. As we assign tasks for the war game, we decide that Mate will defend with me, while Lucino will be leading the invading forces. Let the best warlords win. Hey, a special tithe. Ah, love it. At the beginning of the war game, your enemy decides to do a strong frontal assault towards your center flank. Use all means to reinforce and strengthen the center. Slowly withdraw the forces in the center. While your troops withdraw from the center flank, Lucino decides to push the center flank hard. Mate suggests that we keep the formation. Let's see, bring all the reserves to the center. Retreat the side flanks to keep the line. Fold the side flanks to surround the enemy. Nah, I don't care if he's upset. I want to surround the enemy. When the opposing forces foolishly advance, we easily surround them, gaining the upper hand as they are unable to break free. It is a decisive victory for the defending team. Good game! Marshall plus one, yeah! And 75 influence, too. Not influence, prestige. What am I talking? What is this, Stellaris? No, Nubble's dwarf has fallen. Oh no, how terrible. It's fine. Did not mean to do that. There we go. Go ahead and disband the ships there. And we'll just slowly siege down this land. Aww, Cheval, my organizer and cavalry leader has died. He was incapable. That is a shame. What do we claim on the Duchy of Moravia? Let's go ahead and get you married to someone that we can do matrilineal. Rainer, sure. You know, I mean, other than that one time that he was extorting people, he served pretty well for a while. What do you want? Nope. Not going to be your commander. Not going to be your commander. I refuse. You cannot trick me into getting killed. You have inherited a barony. Ah, a French barony, too. Good. Very good. Wait, your heir is not of your dynasty? Oh, you guys were matrilineal at one point. It's fine. It's not a big family, so it doesn't matter. I'm sick of always being kind to everyone. Feel my wrath. No! No. It is 2 diplomacy and 5... It's terrible. Looks like I've lost my court physician. Let's go ahead and recruit a new one. I hope I do not have to wait long. Your rangers report of an erudite herbalist who resides in a hut in the outskirts of a nearby town. The herbalist, named Clara, seems eager to accept the offer of becoming your personal physician, and has prepared an immense bundle of strange herbs to be delivered to the court should she be accepted. So it's because she's got the erudite trait. She's not a mystic or anything like that. She's a gardener. Ah, yes, herbal remedies sound good. Bring her to court. I need... You always need one. Much rather have a mystic, but what are you going to do, right? Seriously? You just landed 500 troops to attack 10,000. Not the best of ideas... If I get too much higher than 25, then I am gonna, I'll just give the, you know, transfer the vassalage of these under someone else. Someone who likes me, kind of thing. You know... I may as well siege this down, as long as, you know, we're not doing anything with that army. I think it's one of the Amalfi families or something. I can now request a Rana Cup, and also... Go ahead and ransom you two. What's this, Naomi for Jerusalem, huh? Let's hope that doesn't happen. Thank you. And thank you. Seriously. What are you, dumb? All right, Lancelin was captured. Can I ransom you? Nope. Shouldn't you be off prosecuting this war? Ignoring me? Letting me take your land? You know, it's one-for-one trade. Seems reasonable to me, right? Move over there. Try to slowly regain troops, something like that. La-da-da-da-da. Oh, realm peace is ended. Alright, well, I will have about 5 years that I can go on wars. So once this is done, I think that I will focus on Susa here. This guy actually has a weak claim on it already. I'm not sure that I can press it. I've got raised troops anyway. But with two, I might be able to revoke, usurp it. Well, it said... Oh, well. It said raiders had arrived there, but not really. Well, so what exactly is going on here? Milited revolt. Increased council power, and Fatimid Holy War for Kartli. It's actually in favor of Fatimids. That is unfortunate. Oh, interestingly enough, since these are apparently Burgundian liberation revolts, they will exist as long as Burgundy exists, or they will exist until Burgundy exists. Flanders? Are you... Okay, War to Revoke Thuars. The Holy Roman Emperor could just create Burgundy and give it out, and that would eliminate the that revolt. Where exactly are you going? I mean, if you go to one of my lands, I'm just going to raise my my levies. You're in deep thought as your court physician, Clara, suddenly interrupts you. My king, I know that both you and the queen desire an heir for the realm. If you wish, I could research ways to enhance your virility, all in order to facilitate the creation of a worthy successor. What are you insinuating? I don't need help. Yes. please go ahead. Clara begins looking for ways to increase your fertility. I am pleased to hear that after a period of peace and shrewd management, the County Florence is doing very well. People are happy, and the tax collectors are reporting record intakes. Florence prospers. Yes. Yes, keep it going. I have a lot of money. I could afford, Economic tech points might be a little bit better. Although... With as much money as I have, let's just go for this, because we'll probably need it eventually. Court physician Clara approaches you with a smile on her face. I have succeeded, my king. If you drink this concoction, your potency will magnify tenfold. The royal bloodline is saved. I am only 26 years old. Well... I have never actually seen this this event chain before, so what's the worst that could happen? Click this button, become a eunuch. Shortly after drinking the concoction, you feel a pleasant mist clouding your senses. As you emerge from the blur, you find yourself in the royal bedchamber, and not alone. It seems as if the concoction might have been a tad too effective. What happened? I gain lustful and homosexual. I also gain plus 25% fertility. The queen, who is also homosexual, falls in love with me. Countess Maria falls in love with me. Oda falls in love with me. Sophia falls in love with me. Botolf falls in love with me. Count Leobrand falls in love with me. Hmm. Welp.
Welp.
So, in other words, we just had an orgy. That's what I'm taking away from this. Welp. I mean, I did gain a total of 45 fertility. Well, And my homosexual queen is now in love with me. I guess. Oh, have I been standing here and not actually... Ah, shoot. I think I've been standing there and not actually, gaining anything out of that for a little while. That is a lot more troops there. Count Ferruccio of Seleucia knows about my affair with Countess Maria. He knows the child she carries is actually mine. How embarrassing! Fate smiles upon me. My wife, Adelaida, is pregnant. So, yeah, I think that we basically just had an orgy. I have inherited the county of Genoa and other titles? Holy cow! All right. I don't know how that worked, but I'm okay with that. All right, City of Genoa. If I create a new vassal here, they should be Italian. Yes, he sucks, but grant landed title, the County of Genoa, and all lower titles. Okay, and then grant landed title, the Duchy of Genoa. And there we go, new great houses. And I think they should be all Italian. Yes. Fantastic. Okay. So now we finally got Genoa out of the hands of the Germans. And we will have a new merchant republic there, although Pisa kind of dominates that area. There's not a whole lot that Genoa can do. I suppose they could theoretically go to war over some of those things, but I sort of doubt they will. Let's see, we're at 70% here. I am getting a ticking war score for that. You're not gonna just agree to it, are you? Nope. I'm losing, but I won't give up yet. The Teutonic Order. In an effort to defend Poland against pagan attacks, King Piskla has granted the Teutonic Order the county of Lübeck. This county has never been fully settled, and many of the population are still heathens. This noble gesture could help protect the endangered frontier of Poland, as well as further the holy war against the pagans. The infidels should tremble. Although Pomerania is now Christian. Wait. Is Lübeck different from Lübeck? Apparently it is. Okay, so they hold that territory now. Not entirely sure that there's a whole lot of pagans around there, though. Oh, it's Sunni. That's part of it. Yeah, I mean, most of the pagans are up here. That is a blockage against, like, Tertaroba, though, so I guess it's not too bad. Could be worse. Ooh, Seljuk Revolt. I'd really like to see something like a Fatimid revolt or something like that. He's got, he is gaining decadence. He's got 34 1,000 troops, though, which is more than I can handle. Peasants have risen up in Monferrato. Really? Alright, I will just use my own levies here. Take them out. But we will take care of that in the next episode. For now, we'll go ahead and call this an episode, and when we return, we'll take a quick check at how many troops the Holy Roman Emperor has. Only 11,000. Yes, when we come back, we will continue our wars down in Sicily. I would like to get enough land to create Italy, the Empire of Italy, before I... well, actually, I think I might have that. I don't know that I need Sicily for that. Yeah, I don't, which means I actually should be going after this. Let's see. Italia. Alright, I need 80%. Oh, no, I think I also need to... I do also need to be king of Sicily as well, apparently. Alright. Alright, good to know. Alright, so, actual territory doesn't matter that much right now. But when we come back, we will continue to try to get the land from Sicily. See you next time, everyone.